With the 4th of July just around the corner, some of you out there have already started stockpiling your firework arsenal, and no collection is complete without the old standby, sparklers. Today we're taking a super slow-mo, up-close look at the chemistry of sparklers, and we're gonna shine some light on how these things just keep burning on and on. Okay, now before we light this sucker up, let's take a look at what it's made of. Sparklers are a thin wire shaft, usually iron, that has a top coated in a combustible paste. This paste consists of several components: fuels, oxidizers, colorants, and a binder to make it all stick together. For a fuel source, this sparkler uses iron, but there are other substitutions like these. Okay, so let's light this sucker up. When ignited, these powdered metals react with oxygen. To keep it burning, oxidizers like these decompose when heated, producing oxygen, which fuels the reaction. This gas production then blasts tiny ignited fragments from the shaft, producing the classic sparkler effect. These sparks you're seeing are metal pieces that launch out, ignite, and burn in the air. The binder that's most commonly used for sparklers is dextrin, which is important not only because it keeps all those chemicals uniformly together, but also because it slowly decomposes during the reaction, slowing the whole process down for your amazement. Dextrin is also a pyrotechnic fuel, but it has a limited effect on sparklers. Other compounds can be added to the mixture to give the reaction a little bit of color. Most commonly, you're going to find yourself some red, white, and blue sparklers for the 4th, and to get this good old-fashioned American color palette, you're going to need these elements. When little fragments like these shoot off of the sparklers, they're incredibly hot. I'm talking 1,000 to 1,600 degrees Celsius hot. So then you might be wondering why it doesn't hurt when your hand is up close to the sparks. Even though they have a super high temperature, they have very little thermal energy due to their incredibly small mass. But be careful, touching the sparkler at the source of the reaction can cause some serious burns. You can see after the ignition that the iron shaft is glowing bright red. Iron retains heat much longer than these sparklers, so be careful with that thing. We want to give a shout out to our friends over at Compound Interest who put together an awesome infographic about sparklers. Check down in the video description for a link. If you want to learn more about the 4th of July, make sure to check out this video about the chemistry of fireworks. And while you're at it, here's one about the chemistry of grilling. You know the drill, folks. Post a comment if you have any chemistry questions you need answered, or if you have anything you want to see in slow-mo, let us know. Hit thumbs up and subscribe on the way out, and we'll see you again very soon.